friends, welcome to my channel Creative Art. I am Nilima
and today friends, we are going to make this ethnic, beautiful Indian folk art which is Kalamkari painting. Kalamkari is a type of hand painted or block printed cotton textile produced in Indian state of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Only natural dyes are used in Kalamkari and it involves 23 steps. But don't worry friends, as I have simplified all the steps for you so that you can make this beautiful and ethnic Kalamkari painting yourself. So friends, please do watch the whole video and do subscribe my channel friends for more creative art painting videos and do press the bell icon to get notifications for each video I post every week. In olden days friends, to make a Kalamkari painting was a process of at least 42 steps which included different washes, bleach, stamp, Kalamkari and coloring using natural dyes. But in modern generation friends, as the steps are simplified, so is the painting. So I'm going to do this 42 steps Kalamkari painting in very easy and few steps by using the already available color for the fabric which is from Fabrica. It's written acrylic color but you can also use it on fabric, leather, terracotta and wood. And next, as a cloth, I'm going to use a simple cotton cloth. I bought just a meter of cream color cotton cloth for rupees 90 and few fine hair brushes. I'm going to use a round hair brush number 2, number 1, number 0 and number 00. Okay, so let's start this painting now friends. First of all friends, I'm going to dip my piece of cloth into water and keep it there for at least 1 hour. In this way, you have to dip it completely as this is a new cloth. After 1 hour, I'll remove the cloth. Squeeze it just a little bit. And then I'm going to put it to get dry. Now here I have put the cloth to get dry, so it will get dry in about 1 to 2 hours. Now friends, my cloth piece has got dried up completely, so I'm going to put it on my table under which there is a cloth and we're going to iron it. And now I'll iron the cloth. So in the same way friends, I'm going to iron the whole piece of cloth. Well, now friends, my ironing is finally completed and you can see the fabric is straight without any wrinkles. So this is my reference friends which I'm going to use for this painting and these are my yellow carbon paper. So first of all, I'll place the carbon paper sheets exactly on place where I want it to be. Then using tape, I'll secure each one of them with the cloth and also each other in this way because it's a huge piece and we are going to need 4 carbon papers. So I'll stick all of them with the cloth in this way. Smooth all the tops and then finally on it, I'm going to place my reference and again secure my reference with the tape and then secure my reference with the tape on the cloth. You can also use pin. Okay friends, so now all my sides of the reference, the carbon paper and cloth are secured. If you want, you can cut the extra piece of cloth which is not required. And now I'm going to start the tracing part using a pen. You have to go all over the design in this way so that your design is traced on the fabric. Tracing is a bit time-taking process friends, so I'm going to complete it myself and then I'll show you how the tracing has come up, okay? So now friends, this is how our tracing part looks when the whole tracing is finally completed. It is very faint and that would be the best because it won't leave any colors then. So now friends, this is how our design looks after I have imprinted it on our fabric. So now I'm going to start the Kalamkari part and for that I'm going to use black color and I'm doing it using a fine round hair brush. So friends, in the same way, I have completed doing the Kalamkari part, which is the black lining part you can see here. And after that, friends, I have started giving the background as red, because this time I really wanted the background to brighten up the space, and red was the perfect choice for it. So I have colored the background using Fabricryl acrylic color crimson red. In this way, friends, you have to just take the crimson red color in your brush, mix it with just a little bit of water, and then start painting the background as red. So friends, this is how our painting looks when I have finally completed doing the red color part. Now we are going to start coloring the leaves, and for that I have decided four different color shades. First of all, I'm going to use purple, the next is orange, the third is yellow orange, and the fourth is olive green color. So randomly I'm going to color all the leaves using these four colors, and I'm also going to do the shading just using white with the single colors. Now friends, I'm first of all going to start with yellow orange color. I'll directly place the yellow orange color in the leaf part where I want to color it. Then wipe my brush and take just a little bit of white in the brush and go all around the shape of the leaf. Wipe my brush again. And then slightly mix the white with the yellow orange directly using the same brush. This will give a highlight to your leaf. I'm going to randomly color the leaves in different colors. So now I'm using olive green color. I'll fill it completely. Then wipe my brush and use just a little bit of white and give it on the border of the leaf to give it a shape and pop up. Wipe my brush again and then mix the white with the green color. Next, I'm going to use orange, and in the same way, I'm going to repeat the process. Fill up the leaf with the base color and then use just a little bit of white to give it a pop-up highlight. Now I'm using royal purple color. So in this way, friends, I'm going to color all the leaves just using these four different shades, and I'm going to select the shades randomly so that the painting will look much more beautiful. So friends, in the same way, I will be coloring all the leaves and then show you how does it looks. Now friends, this is how our painting looks when we have finally completed coloring all the leaves. And now I'm going to start coloring the flowers. For that, I'm going to use ultramarine blue color first. I'll fill up the whole petal using ultramarine blue. And then I'm using white color to give it a highlight and shading. Use just a little bit of water in brush and start mixing both the colors. First of all, I'm going to use ultramarine blue color. Color 3/4 of the petal using it. And then use the white color. Start coloring it from the tip of the petal and then start mixing it with the blue. Now friends, we are going to color these flowers. For that, first of all, I'm going to use ultramarine blue color and fill up the center part of the petal. And now friends, I'm going to do the outline of the same petal by using a combination of same ultramarine blue and white. So friends, I'm going to do the same for all the flowers with the same design. So friends, in the same way, I'm going to color all these flowers and then show you how does it looks. Okay. Now friends, I'm going to start coloring the elephant, and for that, I have selected to color it gray. Now I'm going to use a white color and do a little bit of shading, mixing it with gray. Now at the top of the trunk, I'm using just a little bit of darker shade of gray to give it a shading. And now friends, I'm using white color at the bottom of the trunk, and then I'm going to mix it using gray, so it will be a combination of gray and white shading. Now friends, I'm going to place white color at the bottom of the trunk. And now I have wiped my brush and used just a little bit of water to mix the gray and white together. Now friends, I'm going to use gray color and do the coloring on the body. And now I'm using white to add a shading from the border of the lines. Now friends, in the same way, I'm going to color the baby elephant using just gray color. Now friends, we are going to start coloring the peacock. First of all, I'm going to use a red color and start coloring from the head of it. Next, I'm going to use purple color to fill up the design. Now again, I'm going to use a red color and color the half feathers as red first. And now friends, I'm going to use olive green color at the bottom of the feathers. I won't be mixing both the colors. I will be keeping them as it is. Now friends, we are going to start coloring the border part, and for that, first of all, I'm going to use purple color. Now I'm using just a little bit of white color to add the shading. Now friends, I'm going to use ultramarine blue color for the next flower. Now I'm using just a little bit of white to do the shading part. So friends, in the same way, I'm going to repeat these four colors, which is purple, yellow orange, ultramarine blue and olive green color to do the boundary of this painting. So friends, in the same way, I'm going to complete all the detailing parts and then I'll show you how does it looks, okay? So friends, this is how beautiful our Kalamkari painting looks when it is finally completed. Let me show you a close-up view of it. Here friends, you can clearly see the detailing parts we have done in the peacock, how beautiful and elegant it looks. And as we move upwards, you can see the shrub climbing upwards with the beautiful blue flowers with the red center and multicolored leaves. While framing friends, you don't need to give any kind of varnish. You can simply frame it with a simple wooden brown frame with a single gold line. So friends, this is the final view of our beautiful Kalamkari painting. Please give it a try. Decorate your corners. Give it an Indian touch by adding this painting in your collection. And tell me in the comments below friends, how did you find my videos? And if you do like my videos friends, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.